And let me begin, I think. The first witness, the gentleman from Texas, is going to introduce.
Thank you, Mr. Chairman. Chairman Frank, Ranking Member Backus, I am pleased to welcome Radley Balko, Senior Editor of Reason Magazine, one of my favorite publications, to the hearing. Mr. Balko is one of the most perceptive critics of government policies that prevent individuals from engaging in what the government considers immoral or unhealthy behavior. Mr. Balko's defense of civil liberties has appeared in a wide range of publications, including the Wall Street Journal, the Washington Post, and FoxNews.com. His writings on the militarization of law enforcement were cited by Justice Stephen Breyer's dissent in Hudson versus Michigan case. I'm sure my colleagues will benefit from Mr. Balko's thought on how banning internet gambling is inconsistent with constitutional government and a free society. Welcome.
Please go ahead.
Thank you.
Let me thank you. I know you went to some considerable trouble to get here, and we appreciate that.
Sure. Thank you, Congressman Paul. Mr. Chairman, distinguished members of the committee, again, my name is Radley Balko. I'm a senior editor with Reason Magazine. I was also a former policy analyst at the Cato Institute. I've spent a good deal of my time writing and researching civil liberties issues, including the problems associated with the prohibition of victimless crimes. I also would like to commend Chairman Frank for his work defending individual freedom, and I thank the committee for inviting me today. The Unlawful Internet Gambling Act was passed under rather dubious circumstances and passed the U.S. Senate on the last day of Congress, late at night, with no floor debate after being attached to an unrelated port security bill. My problem with how the bill passed, however, is beside the point. Let's get to the crux of this issue, Mr. Chairman. What Americans do in their own homes, with their own money, on their own time, is none of the federal government's business. Take online poker, by far the most popular form of online gambling. Poker has enjoyed a surge in popularity over the last several years. The game is about as mainstream and uniquely American as baseball. Poker evolved from similar card games in the early 1800s, then flourished in popularity on Mississippi's riverboats, winning over such iconic American aficionados as Mark Twain. Today, most daily newspapers have a poker column, including the New York Times. The game saturates cable television, and until recently, even members of the Supreme Court had a monthly poker game. Online poker is merely a new evolution of the game, similar to the way Civil War poker games introduced the straight and gave us variations like draw and stud poker. The internet merely removes the geographic barrier preventing those who love the game from finding opponents of similar skill who are willing to wager similar amounts of money. No one is hurt when two or more consenting adults sit down for a game of poker, be it online or in person. Why any of this should be of concern to the federal government is rather perplexing. I respect the fact that many Americans and many members of Congress may have moral objections to gambling, online or otherwise. To them, I'd say simply, well, don't gamble then. But in a nation where Las Vegas is one of our fastest growing cities and most popular tourist destinations, where Indian casinos are commonplace, where horse racing is a national pastime, and where nearly every state in the union derives public funds from state lotteries, singling out internet gambling for prohibition seems arbitrary and, frankly, hypocritical. Yes, it's possible that a parent could bet away their family savings or their child's education fund in an online poker game. They could also fritter that money away on eBay or on booze or fancy cars and exotic travel. But these are personal decisions. And if a free society means anything, it means we should have the freedom to make bad choices in addition to good ones. The ban on internet gambling punishes the millions of Americans who were wagering online responsibly due to anecdotal evidence of a few who may do so irresponsibly. It's an affront to personal responsibility and symptomatic of a nanny statist government that treats its citizens like children. A government based on the principle of liberty doesn't police the personal lives of its citizens for bad habits at any level, much less at the federal level. Supporters of a ban on internet gambling say the industry is unregulated, that underage people are likely to gamble online, and that it supports money laundering and similar criminal enterprises. But these are all problems wrought not by consenting adults' decision to gamble, but by the government's decision to prohibit it. Were Congress to give its blessing to legalized online gambling, I'd suggest you'd soon see brand names like Harrah's, MGM, and Trump immediately enter the market. Reputable offshore brands like Full Tilt Poker and Party Poker would almost certainly incorporate in the U.S. and subject themselves to U.S. market regulation and government oversight, including foolproof age restrictions. Customers want to know that they're playing a fair game, that their bankrolls are secure, and that their privacy is protected. Companies that set up shop in the U.S. with the blessing and encouragement of the U.S. government will almost certainly dominate the market. Winnings could be taxed. market forces, and if necessary, the federal government, could regulate and monitor gaming sites for fairness and transparency. Most importantly, if online gambling were decriminalized, the federal government could get out of the trivial business of breaking up online poker games, and federal law enforcement officials and prosecutors could expend taxpayer-funded resources on more appropriate endeavors, like pursuing interstate fraud, theft, and protecting the country from terrorism. In closing, the Unlawful Internet Gaming Act is a significant and disturbing encroachment on individual liberty. I'd urge the committee to correct this overreach and let Americans do as they please within the privacy of their own homes. Thank you.